The goal in this video is to learn DT Simulator's basic functionalities. We run a Monte Carlo simulation analysis on top of a discounted present value cash flow model like this one. Observe the set of five variables that have an impact on the forecasted five-year flows of a business. Sales, variable, and fixed costs appear. We obtain a profit. We subtract the income tax to calculate an after-tax profit, considering the amount of the initial investment. The model is deterministic in as much as each of these variables has a fixed value without admitting the variability that they might have within a range of a minimum and a maximum values. Once the cash flow is calculated at present value, discounting at a rate of 10%, we consider the NPV and consider the internal rate of return to evaluate the investment. Once the model is structured, the next step is to transform it from deterministic to probabilistic. In other words, inserting the variability in each of these variables, in this case, specified by minimum and maximum amounts. Let's start with the initial sales. Here, we substitute the value of 5,000 for a DT function. We write equals DT, the name of the function. We are going to use a PERT function, which is a function that admits three parameters, a minimum, a most likely value or mode, and a maximum. We then refer to the initial sales, 4,000, 5,000 as the most likely value and 7,000 as the maximum. We close parentheses. We then have a function in the cell that varies each time we recalculate our model. DT Simulator has 13 of the most popular discrete and continuous probability distributions for creating custom models. To insert them into a cell, simply type equals DT and then choose the function you want to use with its respective parameters. The distribution charts will give you instant information about the variables you are creating. The distribution graphs button allows enabling or disabling the graphical display of the shape of the curve on the hover cell where there's a DT function. Now consider the second year sales, which are essentially the previous year sales multiplied by 1 plus a sales growth rate. That growth rate, in turn, has been specified with a minimum value, a mode, and a maximum. That is, we substitute it in turn for a PERT function, DTPERT, referring specifically to the minimum value on B2, the most likely value or mode on C2, and the maximum value on D2. We close the parentheses, and on that cell, we can visualize how the cell of the function will behave within it. We copy the cell respectively for years 3, 4, and 5. If copying and pasting is not possible, it is because DT Simulator is in automatic recalculation mode. We change the calculation mode so that it is now deactivated, and that allows us to make copies over the cells. Now we can copy the DT PERT functions for the sales cells on all periods. We do the same with variable costs as a proportion of sales. We replace the deterministic value with a probabilistic function, DT PERT, making use of the minimum value before, C4, D4, we close parentheses. We can in turn copy this formula for the next 5 years. With fixed costs, the same. We write a DT per function referring to cell B3, C3, D3, we close parentheses. We copy it for the rest of the years. Positioned in cell B14, we now proceed to modify the initial investment. This refers to the amount of the investment or CapEx. We write equals, then with a negative sign, minus DT PERT, and refer to the three respective parameters of minimum, most likely, and maximum. In this way, we have added variability to our model. In each recalculation, random numbers are generated for all stochastic or probabilistic variables that we have added to the model. However, this does not mean that stochastic variables have been defined as input variables. In DT Simulator, the input variables have to be previously and explicitly declared as such. In this case, the respective summaries in column H, sales, variable costs, and fixed costs, are respectively the summary statements of the input variables. So, we can choose the range H9 through H11. We click on the input date button and DT Simulator declares those variables as inputs. Now, These have been specified in green as input variables. By clicking on the button, Show Inputs and Outputs, we see that they have been declared here. Cell B14, Initial Investment, must also be declared an input variable. We have to change the name shown by default because in this case, the variable corresponds to the amount of the initial investment. We confirm. The cell is colored green as an input variable. We can see this with the button Show Inputs and Outputs with its name correctly specified. We also have to explicitly declare the output variables. We select the two cells with output variables, NPV and IRR, respectively. Let's go to output data. Here, they are with their names specifically detected. We add them, and they have been declared as we see here. The color button allows you to turn off the background color of the variables so that we can choose to see a background color for them. Green for input variables, blue for output variables, or as we have specified, also see them all together with the button Show Inputs and Outputs. The model has now been transformed from deterministic to probabilistic. In each recalculation, F9, we have noticed variability in each of these moving parts that the model has. We are ready to simulate. By clicking on the parameters button, we can specify how many iterations or recalculations will be generated during the simulation. In the student version, we can run up to 1,000 iterations. DT Simulator will not allow generating more than 1,000 iterations in this version. 1,000 iterations is enough to show the impact of what a Monte Carlo simulation does, although it is usually a relatively small number to make professional level conclusions in a formal decision-making process. Here, you can also specify which variables you want to show in the histogram. What are the 20th and 80th percentile values and the target values? Since we want to assess the probability that the NPV is greater than zero, it is defined as a target value. You could also define any secondary target value. We confirm, and right here we tell DT Simulator to run the simulation. If we decide not to run the simulation this time, the Simulate button always allows us to run the simulation later on. During it, DT Simulator will generate 1,000 different scenarios for each of the input and output variables, making the values of each variable vary over the specified range. Having finished the simulation, we can save the results. That is, copy from RAM to a data sheet and an external workbook in the same folder where the file is saved, storing the simulated results. In this case, the results have been saved successfully, and if you wanted, you could see them by clicking on the Simulated Data button. This allows you to visualize, in this case, 1,000 rows or iterations for, firstly, the two output variables and then the input variables. Clicking on Simulated Data will, again, hide the sheet. Now we proceed to do the graphical analysis of the output variables. Positioning your cursor over the NPV, we click on the histogram icon to see the histogram that summarizes all the simulated points for the NPV. Here, we read that the range of possible results has an approximate minimum of minus 2200 to a maximum of over 6300, with an approximate mean of 800 and a median, or 50th percentile, of approximately 700. A specification of the two percentiles is included. The first target probability value of x less than or equal to 0 indicates that there's approximately a 30% probability that the NPV of this project is less than or equal to zero. That is, in approximately 7 out of 10 possible outcomes, this project has a positive NPV. Also, on the target value 2 with a value of 1,000, there's about a 57% probability that the results will be less than or equal to that magnitude. We obtain additional statistical information and information about the simulation. This histogram analysis can be done for the input variables as well. I can generate a histogram on any of the variables that have previously been declared as input variables. We can also generate S-type curves, also known as percentile or cumulative probability graphs. Multiple variables can be selected simultaneously using the control key while selecting either input or output variables. Thus, they will be displayed in an S-type graph, where the magnitude of the variables expressed in the specified currency is measured on the x-axis, and the cumulative probability for each point on the curves is measured on the y-axis. This information has also been saved in JPEG files in the same directory where the original file resides. We can also generate tornado graphs as long as we have previously positioned ourselves on an output variable. If I try to generate a tornado having positioned the cursor on an input variable, DT Simulator will not let it, because by definition, tornado graphs are generated on output variables. Here we observe, for example, that the input variable of sales is, with respect to the measurement of the correlation coefficient, the one with the greatest impact on the net present value, which was the output cell where we were previously positioned ourselves. In that sense, we can also see the information by hovering over the sales input variable, and in this case, clicking on the scatter plot on the NPV, so that we can see the sales on the x-axis and the net present value on the y-axis. We observe its correlation coefficient. In other words, the degree of association of all the 1,000 iteration points generated with respect to the line of best fit, which is measured by that coefficient of 0.80. Any input or output variable can be put into a scatter plot, and the respective correlation coefficients can be observed between the variable on the x-axis and the variable on the y-axis. DT Simulator allows the specification of its icons and its visual aids in the language respectively selected in your Excel ribbon. For example, if we change the language to English, DT Simulator will take you to the English site where we can see many additional videos that specify in greater detail what we're explaining here, about the functionality of the software and about the practical use of some example models. Back in Excel, in the icon About DT Simulator, enable the serial code that will allow us to access the professional version. The professional version allows a much higher number of iterations, a greater number of declared inputs and output variables to create more robust professional models with more convergence and stabilized summary data.